Hey guys, how's it going? Hope everybody's doing well today. Back in August of 2022, we took a look at a paste bin clone called LenPaste, and I've been using it basically since then as a public kind of code repository. In fact, it's even listed on LenPaste's website as a public code repository. It's been great. I've had no issues with it. Until recently, over the last few weeks, I haven't been able to run updates. I haven't been able to communicate with their server. Then I saw that they moved their server back over to GitHub from their own private repository. And even then, the manifests aren't downloading when we try to do updates to the newest versions. So over the last couple of weeks, I've been looking for a replacement for it, and I've looked at several different pastebin kind of clones or replacements, whatever you want to call them there. And after looking at several, I found some that I liked and some that I didn't like. And in this video, I want to show you one that I do like that's very, very close to LenPaste, but this is called Hasty-Paste. Okay, so here we are on my desktop, and this is LenPaste. If you've seen that video, if you use LenPaste, of course, you're going to be familiar with this. Unfortunately, right now, updates aren't working for any number of reasons. I don't know what's going on behind the scenes over there, but updates aren't working, even though there are supposedly updates. Anyway, here is Hasty-Paste. And if we put them side by side, they look very similar with just some aesthetic changes. There are, you know, different features on each one, but I can't keep using something that's not getting updates, that it seems to be having a lot of issues. So we're gonna take a look at getting Hasty-Paste installed here. So first we'll take a look at it though. I think that's important. You know, we can give it a title. We'll just call it a test paste. We can set the expiration if we want it to expire on a certain date, a certain time, whatever. We can select all of that here. We've got highlighting, you know, that we can, that we have lots of different options here for different types of code highlighting. So I dig that. So let's actually, let's come over to here. Let's grab something. Oops. I'm just going to grab the Docker Compose for this. It's very, very basic, and we'll talk about it. But so we paste that in there. You know, we can say our highlighting is going to be YAML because that's what this is. We're not going to do any expiration or anything like that. And then we're going to click create. And there it is. Everything looks good. It's highlighted based on the code that I told it that it was, in this case, a YAML file. Here we've got the option to view raw. We can download it. We can copy and share the link, which I dig. LenPaste didn't have that feature, just as a button. So again, it's little things sometimes that make all of the difference. And to go along with the little things that make all of the difference, there's also clone and edit, which I love. So let's say somebody shares this with me and I'm like, you know, that's fine, but maybe I want to change some things in this. I can click clone and edit, and then I can make my edits. You know, I don't want this there. I want this to be on $89.99, and we'll call this test paste 2. And again, we'll say YAML, like so. And again, no expiration date or anything, but when we click create, so we were able to easily just clone the existing paste that was there and then modify it and save it as our own. So sometimes it is just the little details that make all of the difference, having the ability to copy and share a link by just clicking a button. I really dig that. Same thing with the clone and edit. It may not get used a lot, but knowing that it's there, knowing that we can clone that and make it our own and save it without affecting the original paste that was there, I think is a really cool little touch that they've added to this. There are some additional resources that we'll take a look at as far as modifying the Docker Compose, which we will take a look at here in just a moment. But I really dig it. So let's take a look at what the Docker Compose looks like, and then also what the additional environment variables are and the different things we can do to modify the Docker Compose to make it our own setup. Here we are. We're taking a look at Hasty-Paste's Docker Compose in Hasty-Paste, because that's where we put it just for testing this thing out. And if we take a look, the version, we've got a Docker Compose of version 3, which will be perfectly acceptable. Different versions of Docker Compose give us different features, and this is perfectly acceptable. There's nothing crazy going on here. We've got services listed as pastebin. This really should be like Hasty-Paste, I think, but it is what it is. Container name also, I think, should be Hasty-Paste, but the dev has put in pastebin. You can change these two things without affecting anything, just if you wanted to. Our image is going to pull from the GitHub container repository. The user is enchant97, and the image that we're going to use, my brain died on me for a second. So the image we're going to use is Hasty-Paste, and the version will be the latest version of that. We're going to have a restart policy of unless stopped. So if something goes wrong, the container will make every effort it can to bring itself back up, say on a server reboot, something like that. Our volumes, you could do like a mapped volume here if you wanted to, where it was like home, Docker, Hasty-Paste, and then data. But because there's really nothing in that to modify, you don't need to change that. You can just leave this as a Docker volume, but just make sure that you don't change. Well, if you're gonna leave it as a Docker volume, I wouldn't change anything on this line. But if you really wanted to, you could change the name of the volume here, as long as you change it down here on line 14 as well. But don't change anything. Don't change the colon or anything after that. That's going to be super important. And then our ports, we set our port when we did this little kind of clone and edit thing to port 8999, for the browser side, the consumer side of things. Whereas on the inside of the container, it's going to be on port 8000. Don't change the colon or the port 8000 there. That's what the container is looking for specifically. So that's it. That is a very basic installation for Hasty-Paste, and that's more or less what I'm using here. But as I mentioned earlier, there are some additional environment variables that we can use to kind of add functionality and change some things in our setup. So we'll go ahead and take a look at that. Then we'll go ahead and get this thing installed, and it just takes a couple of moments to do that. So let's jump over and take a look at the environment variables before we install it. So here we are on Hasty-Paste's homepage. Of course, everything will be linked in the video description if you want to check that out. But basically, it gives you an idea of what Hasty-Paste is. Again, it's a pastebin clone or alternative, if you want to call it that. Lots of good information here. What we want to do is come over to the install section. And it says this section will demonstrate how Hasty-Paste can be installed and configured. And we've already got the Docker compose, and I believe it's down here somewhere. There it is. You can also do it with Redis if you wanted to do that. You can do it with S3 integration if you want to do that. You can do it without Docker if you want to go that route as well. So basically, I think just to spice things up a little bit, we're going to use Redis for our setup just because it should help kind of speed things up with caching and that sort of thing. But if we scroll back up, there are a bunch of different environment variables that you can use in your Docker compose to do different things and change default values if you want to do that. So for instance, if we take a look like at the time zone, the default is Europe, London. You can change that if you want to or need to. New at index, which I actually really dig. And basically that allows us to just immediately drop into a spot where we can paste code rather than some random homepage. So I like new at index to be added to that. Public list, decides whether or not to enable public asset access, for listing pages, true or false. Again, I'm not sure what I like on that. Honestly, I can see why people might want their privacy, but if you wanted to, you could enable it. You can use a long ID. You can set the default expiration time in minutes, hours, days. Storage type, you can do that as well. Defaults to disk, which is what we're going to do. You can enable a cache by default. That's true. So all kinds of different stuff in here. We're not going to go through all of this, but lots of different stuff in here that you can use to modify your Hasty-Paste install to fit your needs. So what we're going to do, we're going to scroll down. We're actually going to, like I said, we're going to grab this Redis version right here. And basically the only thing we're adding to this that wasn't in the previous version that we looked at was this Redis container. The container name will be Redis. The image will be Alpine's version of Redis. We've got a restart policy there also. But we've also got a thing here that depends on Redis. So we've added that. We've also added an environment variable for the Redis URI. We've got a time zone in here. We're going to add a couple of more things, but just some generic stuff that was added just to make the Redis work by default. So let's go ahead and copy this. Then we're going to come over to Portainer. Now, you don't have to install this via Portainer. You could do this through Dockage or through Yacht or through, through a Docker compose.yml file and deploy via command line or whatever the case is. I don't think there's any one right way to do this. Mostly it's going to depend on your level of comfort with each of those different things and finding the right one for you. But for the sake of simplicity, we're going to use Portainer to deploy this. So we're going to come over to my Portainer instance here, and I'm going to come over to Stacks over here in the left-hand side. If you land here and you're here, you can just click Stacks and get there as well. So I'm going to click Add a Stack, and I'm going to paste this in. I'm going to call it Hasty-Paste up here. like so. Now, there are some things that I want to change about this install. For instance, Portainer uses port 8000 by default. So I'm just going to change it to 8999. I think I've got that port available. And there were some additional environment variables that I wanted to add to this. Let's see. Time zone is already there. We're going to add new at index just because I like to just immediately go to where I can drop code versus landing on a homepage and then having to click somewhere to add code. It just removes a step, and I appreciate that. So we're going to change this first. We're going to say America/Denver. And then a new index equals true. These don't really all need quotes around them, but let's stick with it and go ahead and do that. Let's just do that. Time zone we've already fixed. New at index. Cache enable is, so cache is enabled by default. So you would only really want to put that in there if you want to set it to false. So if we just want to change whatever the default value is, you can add that environment variable to it and change it that way. If you see the default value listed that you like, you don't need to add that environment variable to your Docker Compose or your stack in this case. Again, we've got things like branding, title, and description and icon. We don't need to do any of that. I think everything else here is good. I don't think I needed to add that extra line there. So I'm going to go ahead and just remove that like so. So I think we've got everything here set up that we actually need. We've got our time zone set correctly. We've got our Redis cache turned on, and we've got new at index turned on. So that's good. We've got our name for our container. I think we're good to go. So all we've got to do, scroll down and click on deploy the stack. Give this just a second to do what it needs to do to deploy, and then we should be up and running. Okay, so just a couple of moments later, it's up and running. So let's see, pastebin is starting. Redis is already running. Let's see, do I have that? I don't have that correct. Just to avoid any issues, what I'm gonna do is come over here and put an IP address in our environment variables. If you haven't done this already, this is where to do it. Click update, come over here and refresh. And hopefully, there we go. Just that quickly and easily. Now we have a new pastebin alternative up and running for our use. So guys, there we go. That's how easy it is to get Hasty-Paste up and running so that we've got a pastebin clone of our own to store code or share code or whatever we need to do with it. Super easy to get set up. And I really am glad that there's a pretty good analog for LenPaste, because they're going through some issues right now. And I wanted to make sure that people would have a good alternative to that if they wanted to deploy something similar. So that's Hasty-Paste, very easy to deploy. You can throw this on a domain via a reverse proxy if you want to, whether that's, Nginx Proxy Manager, Traffic, Caddy, Swag, Cloudflare Tunnels, whatever the case is. This plays nicely on a reverse proxy without any additional configuration. So I really do dig that. But I think that kind of covers everything I wanted to talk about in this video. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up. I do want to thank you guys for spending a few minutes of your day with me today. One other thing I should mention, if you're not already a patron over on Patreon, these videos usually go live at least a few days in advance of when they go live on YouTube. So if you'd like to not only get early access, but also ad-free access to my content, you can do that by just paying as little as a dollar if you wanted to do that per month. And that would give you access to a whole library of videos with no ad spots, no YouTube ads, anything like that. So yeah, check that out if you're interested, if you're in a place to do that. That would be amazing if you wanted to help support the channel. But I've done enough rambling. I want to thank you guys again for spending a few minutes of your day with me today, and I'll talk to you in the next video.